In the previous video, we learned about the typical structure and external quantum efficiency of 3-5 multi-junction devices. We also discussed the layer-by-layer growth occurring in the epitaxial deposition processes. We will now look at the effects of this layer-by-layer growth. This growth can result in interface defects if different materials are grown on top of each other, such as in multi-junction devices. In this figure, the lattice constant of a bottom material, A1, is larger than the lattice constant of a top material, A0. These materials might, for instance, be gallium phosphide grown on top of gallium arsenide. The interface between these two materials is strained, and not every valence electron at the interface is able to make a bond with a neighbor. These dangling bonds are defects that significantly increase the Shocken-Reed-Rolle recombination of the device. This problem can be solved by lattice matching. Lattice matched materials have a similar lattice constant and interface defects are therefore virtually absent. To understand what this means, we will take a look at this phase diagram. In the phase diagram, the band gap of a number of relevant materials is plotted against their respective lattice constant. We can decide, for example, through simulation, what band gap a cell in a multi-junction device should have for optimal spectral utilization. We can then use the phase diagram to select a material with a matching lattice constant. Let's use the typical 3-5 devices as an example. The bottom cell is germanium and the middle cell is gallium arsenide. As we can see, these materials have similar lattice constants and therefore are lattice matched. For a reasonable current density matching, the desired band gap of the top cell should be around 1.8 electron volts. However, we see that no suitable alloys exist, based on solely two elements. We can reach this point by drawing a line between gallium phosphide and indium phosphide. This means that a lattice match material with the right band gap energy can be realized by alloying gallium, indium, and phosphorus in the correct ratio. Similarly, several combinations of elements can be used to make different materials with a particular lattice constant. Since the typical multi-junction device on the left has three cells with similar lattice constants, this device is lattice matched. You can imagine, however, that integrating more subcells makes it harder for a device to remain lattice matched. We saw earlier in this video that the spectral utilization of this typical 3-5 device can increase by introducing additional cells in between the germanium and gallium arsenide. By looking at the phase diagram, we can see that there is no viable lattice match option for such a material. A trade-off therefore exists for choosing a material in a 3-5 multi-junction device. This trade-off is between using an optimal band gap to maximize the spectral utilization and the optimal lattice constant to minimize the interface recombination caused by dangling bonds. Multijunctions with lattice mismatched subcells are called metamorphic multijunctions. This picture shows a metamorphic device with 5 separate junctions. Metamorphic devices require buffer layers in between the subcells. These buffer layers have a graded profile in the lattice constant, going from the lattice constant of one p-n junction to the lattice constant of the next p-n junction. By using this graded profile, the strain at the interface of the lattice mismatch material is reduced, strongly decreasing the recombination at the interfaces. Using this technology, SpectroLab demonstrated a 38.8% conversion efficiency of a 5-junction solar cell under one sun illumination. In this video, we discussed the structure of a typical 3-5 multi-junction device architecture and its external quantum efficiency. We looked at the defects that can occur at the interfaces of two 3-5 semiconductor materials. The different cells in the 3-5 multijunction device should have similar lattice constant to minimize recombination losses. But we saw that for quadruple or 5-junction devices, it's virtually impossible to make a lattice-matched device with optimal bandgap energies. We therefore discussed the metamorphic solar cells and the graded buffer layers used by these devices. In the next video, we will look into special applications of the 3-5 multijunction solar cells.